PowerDirector 16, how do we do the jitter effect, or the wiggle effect, some call it? It's a cool effect that you can do with text that kind of bounces it around, moves it around. But there's a couple things we need to do to actually do this PowerDirector effect to get it just right. And here are some samples that I'm actually going to teach you how to do, and you can actually expand this even further. So let's get into this on the PowerDirector jitter effect. PowerDirector 16, let's create the jitter effect, or wiggle effect, if you will. First, we need a video. We're going to drop that down there. Voila. We need text. Click on the T here on the left to go into the title room. I'm going to click default, but you can pick whatever one you want. I'm going to drag that down here. Put it there. I'm going to double click on it. Now we can edit my text. Double click this. Type in whatever I want. I don't like that font. It doesn't really give much of a jiggle effect. I'm going to pick this font here, and I'll have a link in the description box if you guys want to pick up some of these fonts. They're free. So there's my font there. I'll leave this one big, and I'll say good. So there we go. Now we need to dress it up. We need to wiggle it a little bit. We're going to go into FX, the effect room, or F4, and we're going to look for Quake or Old Movie. Quake is the one I want, and you can play with quite a few of these, but I'm going to go with Quake, and I'm going to drop Quake on the text. Now, when I give that a quick play, it's moving just a little bit too fast there, as you can see. So I'm going to single click on my text, and I'm going to go to Effect. Now, these numbers I can change here and mess with. So I don't know, I'll cut it down to 30, maybe cut this one down, just play with the numbers, play with it a little bit better, maybe still a bit too fast. Not too bad. So there's a simple setup right there, as you can see, on how to do the jiggle effect. But we can get a little bit more in detail, for example. So let's go here. I'm going to put a text there, and I'm going to put a text underneath it. And I'm going to have two here, okay? I'm going to click this one. And this, I want to get a different effect. So put this up here. And again, I want a different font to give it that look. And I'm going to say OK. My second text I dropped in the box. I want two separate words to have basically two separate effects to give it a different sort of look. Line it up the best you can. And again, we're going to go back to the effects room. We're going to drop Quake on both. Single click them, go to effect. Quark them down a little bit. And I kind of want the effect to be completely different on each one. So if I make one a 30, make the other one a 20. So this way they don't look identical when they're producing the shake. So you see one's a little faster, one's a little slower. So the word wiggles faster, the word effect is slower, wiggles faster. So that's kind of cool. We can do that. So let's get into something even a little bit more different. And I'm going to bring down another text. And I'm going to bring down another text. And again, same thing applies. I mean, and this way I'm going to split the word this time.
And maybe I'll even make that a different color, make it red. Then I'll go into my second one. And you really get quite crazy if you're to do one letter at a time, even. I'll make that one yellow. Find my font again. And like I said, check the description box if you want to have a bunch of fonts that have the jiggle effect look to them. Because it does help with the creating it. So I could move that a bit closer, but I'll leave it separate for now. We're going to go back to FX. We're going to grab our Quake again. We're going to drop it on it. And you notice how it moves it a little bit. So you might want to, after you drop the effect on it, the Quake, you might want to go back into it here. And then actually move it over. So you get that better where it looks like it's all together. Now, if I play that again, really too fast, we really have to click on the actual text, go into effect with the effect button, and we have to tone everything kind of down like that. And the same thing for the bottom one. And now we got both of them kind of wiggling the same though, so maybe I need to tone this one down a little bit more, and I'll even bring this one up more and see what happens. See? So they look a little. You could do each letter if you really want to get quite detailed into creating an effect with this wiggle effect for PowerDirector. Now, one thing probably a lot of people don't know about, and I'm going to show you this here. I'm going to go on back here. And you're actually going to learn two things here. I'm going to go to the wiggle effect here, but you'll notice I have an old movie thing here and Quake. This one's already got Quake in, so I'm going to add old movie to this. And notice how it turned to gray. So now when I actually display it, I've got one gray, one white, and I've got this wiggle effect. Now what a lot of people are not certain of or don't know, when you go into effects, you'll notice there's a box here. And there's a minus sign, and you can go up and down with your effects in this box. You can stack these. You could have multiple effects in here. Turn them off, turn them on, remove them, whatever you want. So I could go here under old movie, and I can really tweak the colors or what I want to do here. Put how much scratch I went in, how much noise. I can really get fancy with this font, is what I can do. Bring that up more, for example. See what I mean? So you can get pretty crazy in here. And like I said, all you got to do is when you're in the FX and go to all, you can take these, drag them down, drop them on your text, and you can stack them one on top of each other. And when you actually click on them and you go into effect, you'll see them in this box here where you can actually now play with them and just tweak it and how you want it to look. Anyhow, there's a quick tutorial on how to do a wiggle effect in PowerDirector 16. At any rate, guys, I'll catch you on the next one. PowerDirector 16, how do we do the jitter effect, or the wiggle effect, some call it. It's a cool effect that you can do with text that kind of bounces it around, moves it around. But there's a couple things we need to do to actually do this PowerDirector effect to get it just right. And here are some samples that I'm actually going to teach you how to do, and you can actually expand this even further. So let's get into this on the PowerDirector Jitter Effect.